Today, I have got a spaghetti squash dinner recipe for you. So if you're interested in that, stay tuned. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, my name is Pamela and I like to share deliciously easy plant-based recipes. So if those are the types of videos that you like, be sure to click that little red subscribe button down below along with the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. This week I have got a spaghetti squash family meal for you. So let's go ahead and jump right in. So this night I'm actually going to rotisserie my spaghetti squash. So I'm going to cut off each end. And unfortunately my knife needs to be sharpened, so it's a little bit difficult. But you don't need to cut off very much because it's really soft right underneath the rind. And then I'm putting the steak of the rotisserie right through the center. I'm not going to cut out the seeds inside or anything. I'm just going to put the steak right through the center, and then I'm going to put the spikes on either end to hold it in place so that it will turn with the rotisserie. And then it's got these little screws that hold those spikes in place on the rotisserie spike. So I'm not sure what the names of all these parts are called. I'm sure there's official names, but I don't actually know them. So once I have this in place, there are two different sides of the rotisserie steak I'll show you. So one side goes in the turning mechanism, and then the other side just rests on like a little, like a little rest on the other side of the oven. So this is the side that just rests on like a little catch, and then this is the side that actually goes into the turner of the rotisserie. And my oven has this nice little handle to help me put it in. So I'll put a link to this oven too down below. I did a lot of research on which oven I wanted to get. So I'll put a link to this one down below. I've got my oven set to rotisserie, 400 degrees, which is the highest. And I set it to 60 minutes, which I definitely do not need that long. You'll see in a second. It did not take that long. And I turned the fan on high and I let it run for a second here so you can kind of see it turn. How cool is that? All right, so here it is. And you can see there was about 14 minutes left there, 14, 15 minutes. And it is nice and brown. I'm trying to get it out without it completely falling apart, but look how tender it is. And then let's see, I'm going to put in some garden meatballs. So we are going super easy tonight. If you want to go whole food plant-based, you can always use white beans. But for this family meal, we are going with the garden meatballs because my kids love them and it's just super easy. All right, so once I've let the spaghetti squash cool down for just a bit, I actually am just letting the metal pieces cool down, and they cool down really quickly. I'm going to go ahead and take the spaghetti squash off of the spikes, and they come off really easily. But look how gorgeous and brown that is. It is so beautiful. And then I'm going to go ahead and cut this in half, and it's still really hot. So be careful when you do this, don't burn yourself. And then, so the seeds are all still in there, and look how the skin just like peels off. This is my new favorite way to cook spaghetti squash, because it makes it so it's nice and dry instead of like a soggy mush. And then the skin just peels right off. It's so easy. Now, sometimes the seeds and the stringy bits in the center come out easier than others, than other times. But either way, you don't lose too much of the actual meat of the spaghetti squash. So don't worry about it too much. The time before this, it literally just scooped out like you were, you know, scooping ice cream or something. It was so easy. And this time it was a little bit more difficult, but a big spoon and a fork, and it comes right out. And so I'm just gonna scoop out the centers of each of these and get them nice and cleaned out. But look how beautiful that spaghetti squash is. It's just, the strings are just coming apart nice and easy. Okay, getting the last few seeds. And if I wanted to, I could keep these seeds and throw them back air fryer oven and toast them up and make like pumpkin seeds with them. That wouldn't be too bad. My kids would love that. Now, this is the amazing part. This is where the magic all happens. So all I have to do is slide a spoon between the meat and the skin, and look at that, it just pops right out. That is so amazing. It is so easy. No more, you know, taking a fork and having to shred the meat out of the skin. It just pops right out in one big clump. How amazing is that? This is my new favorite way to do spaghetti squash. I will never cook spaghetti squash another way again. Well, unless, I guess, if I'm in a hurry, then I'll have to do it in my Instant Pot. But look at that. That's so amazing. And then I just take a fork and fluff it up super quick, and dinner is ready. So, you know, that is pretty much it. So while the meatballs are cooking in the oven, that's pretty much all the time that it takes to de-seed the spaghetti squash, take the skin off, and then fluff it up. So by the time I'm done doing all of this, the meatballs are done air frying, and then we're ready to go ahead and plate everything up. So here, I'm just gonna get a little plate for my daughter. I asked her what she wanted, and she literally just said, like, I just want the spaghetti squash noodles and some cashew Parmesan cheese. So that is literally all that she's getting for dinner. I don't know what it is, but lately my kids do not want dinner. They're just not hungry at the end of the day. And I'm actually shocked that she even asked for this, and she actually ate it all, which was shocking to me. And then here I am plating up my Brightline Eating Friendly Meal. So I'm just gonna go ahead and weigh out my portions, which is a 14 ounce vegetable serving. And then I've been a while since I recorded this, but I believe at this point I was already on my plateau plan. So it's gonna be 3 ounces of the meatballs, and then a half an ounce of the cashew Parmesan cheese. Now, as I mentioned earlier, if you want to keep this a whole food plant-based meal, all you need to do is swap out the pre-made meatballs for some white beans of some sort. So cannellini, northern white beans, anything like that would be absolutely delicious. But there you have it. There is our family spaghetti night dinner. All right, if you want to see more of my recipe videos, go ahead and click on one of these right here, and I will see you next time.